Welcome to this Untangle the Knot Game of Thrones edition. Let's untangle this knot. The problem with the way the show started versus how it ended up being the way it is in the beginning, if you remember seasons 1 and 2 and 3, everybody's out for themselves, everybody's out to survive and to get theirs and really not give back to the country or their city. But now by the end, they're all fighting for this grand cause. They're ready to risk their lives, to give up everything, lose everything. And the question is why, right? What is the quality that they're all acquiring over these 8 seasons? What is the virtue? That virtue, in a word, is duty. Duty is an absolute essential cornerstone of where Game of Thrones is now. Episode 3, all these great warriors are together because of duty. They feel they have an obligation to humanity, to civilization, to Winterfell, to the Seven Kingdoms, right? It's not just about getting what's yours. It's not just about survival, right? And obviously, the Lannisters, right, back at King's Landing are the only ones that are interested in survival. That's why they're not there. Even though by not being present, they are risking the survival of civilization. In their minds, their own survival is higher than the survival of the whole continent, which is counterintuitive, but that's how selfish people are. They're not logically consistent. Whereas by going to the north and being willing to sacrifice yourself, you're actually ensuring your own survival and the survival of your people. That's what duty is, and that's why in the great moments of human history, with the American Revolution, for example, duty and celebration of duty ensured your own survival. And by focusing on your survival, you ended up sacrificing and losing everything you had. So duty is an important value to recover in our culture today as well.